The dream that is the new St. Mary's College is getting closer to reality with each passing day. Work on the new Catholic High School is ahead of schedule. While the $41.5 million project will provide a state-of-the-art school for secondary students, two major components aren't included in the budget. The As One campaign has a goal of $4 million to outfit a theater and multi-purpose all-season outdoor athletic facility. The campaign hits full stride this Thanksgiving with a special celebration, Homecoming Weekend.
It's an opportunity for the alumni from Mount St. Joseph, St. Basil Secondary, as well as St. Mary's College to come together. As well, there will be celebrations Friday night with pub nights and gatherings for each of the respective alumni. Saturday, St. Basil Secondary and St. Mary's College will have a bowl game. Sunday, Theater SMC, the alumni, 25 years they're celebrating on Sunday night, and we're coming together to celebrate as a Catholic community at a Mass at the SR Center on Monday, Thanksgiving Day. And the theme of the Mass is Serving as One. Bishop Plouffe and our pastors from our local parishes will be celebrating. We have a dynamic speaker coming who will be part of the homily at the Mass, Sister Claire Fitzgerald. She's been to our board several times the last few years. And as we serve together as one, we're doing a food collection that will go to the food banks to help those that need those services within our community.
Leaders of alumni groups from Mount St. Joseph College, St. Basil Secondary, and St. Mary's College are assisting the board in preparation for the homecoming weekend activities.
Well, this weekend is considered a homecoming, and we have some events planned. Yes, we have a great association headed by Abby DiDonato, and we've had some events, but this weekend we're hoping to see some of the ex-students returning, some alumni returning from out of town.
Women love to get together, and we love to talk and share stories and reminisce. All of our reunions, our 25th, 40th, and our 50th, and the closing, the women are there in droves because we have so many fond memories of school. So I'm so looking forward to seeing everyone at the homecoming as one. And our pub will be Friday, October 10th, at the Water Tower. So we have a lot of things planned for that night, and I'm just looking forward to the women just being there with their stories.
Well, it's an exciting time because it provides the opportunity for alumni of the Catholic schools to reconnect and come together. And it's a long weekend. It's a perfect time for everyone to get together again. It's very exciting for St. Basil alumni because this is the last year of St. Basil Secondary School. So as of next year, our whole Catholic school system in the secondary schools will be St. Mary's College. So this provides a great opportunity for us alumni to, come together.
This special weekend is just the start of fundraising for the As One campaign. All involved realize how important it is for the campaign to succeed. Creating dynamic arts and athletic environments will allow students at the new St. Mary's College to achieve their academic, emotional, physical, and spiritual goals.
I have to go back to when we first started up at St. Mary's, and we were all boys. We didn't have a lot of the extra facilities that we had even later. And when we moved down to the Lakeway site, we had some people on staff, Joe Lozon, Maria Burgess, that really introduced drama to our curriculum. And it was a fabulous start, and it was due to them that we became recognized throughout the province with our drama. It's a functional part of the school. It's just a program that I think has to be continued. And we're looking at trying to raise some money to furbish a new auditorium at the new school. So this is critical, I think, to the environment within the school, the atmosphere within the school, and the school spirit.
This is a time for our Catholic community to come together. Probably that happened back in the 50s when our high schools, St. Mary's College first with the Basilians, but the parishes and the diocese were very much involved. When the sisters were called upon to open a girls' school, again, the Catholic community mobilized. Here we are 60 years later, almost 60 years later, with the same opportunity. I have no doubt that the community will respond to all the initiatives.
For more details on Homecoming Weekend, visit asonesmc.com. For Shaw TV, I'm Jim Fitzpatrick.